hobo. I thought all those radio people faked me.
You have a question or you just want to sit here and talk all day about my name?
No, that's it. Call the show back. Or John, or Betsy, whatever you think.
All right, next caller, you're on Chatterbox. What is on your mind?
Fruit vegetables. Albino carrots.
Okay, here's the deal. This isn't gardening with the priest. That's on later.
No, he got taken off the air. He lied. I know he did. I've been trying to make a hybrid of a peach and a Pekingese midget fight bitch for the last 2 years. And it is impossible, I tell you.
Okay, and speaking of impossible, Jane from Cedar Grove is on the line, and she wants to talk about how difficult it is being a parent today. Hello, Jane.
Hi, Lachlan. I love the show. It's the first time calling. I wanted to say something about these two. They are one big monkey in mind. My son saw a vehicle that hit by a truck, and he said, Mommy, Mommy, where's the reset button? Kids these days, think twice in a game. Well, it's not a gay one. Very good. I let my kids be with him, and they're all running around the house looking for the
I used to fall unconscious for hours at a time. Now with Equinox, I never get to sleep. Equinox is new from Zaibatsu Pharmaceuticals. Ask your doctor about Equinox today.
Other people talk for a change.
Oh, I'm so off. I'm so important. This is
to me talk about my golf stuff. I think I'll put this outside. Hey, what's the weather like down there? How's it going, shortstop? Is that your clothes? Why so sad, Pee-wee? Who do you think you are? Short people are people, too.
All right, another award-winning show on Chatterbox. Today we're talking about anything, it seems. If you have something to say about anything, call now. Hello, caller. You're on Chatterbox.
Yeah, let's go.
The Lone Star State.
Oh, taxes is really wrong. My father worked his whole life. He played the lottery. Now the state wants to pay taxes on the...
Hello, you are on Chatterbox.
Hello, Lazo. I'm a first-time caller. I recently moved to the
country. Oh, really? How do you like it? I mean, is it hard to get used to the language? You speak English pretty good.
Oh, thank you, Lazo. Yes, if I do like it. There's one thing though, that is not a worry. When I was a boy in England, I had a nanny. She was very sick.
For my people, it is the holiest, most sacrosanct thing imaginable. like a jerk. Yet, for it to be a happy marriage, it must also be like a brother. Sick woman, she must be many, many arts. The skill in making house, cooking, changing the diapers on the baby, and... or a vision of the baby. Imagine if it makes something.
Seems like bliss. I wasn't really up for kissing on air. I mean,
why not? Am I not the easiest to work? Well, no matter. Why all this talking about kissing?
I mean, you brought it up.
No, my friend. You say you not want to kiss me. I was talking how to say, hypothetically, to make me all personal. It's a bit different. If I say, imagine if your wife was ugly. You can nod your head. But if I say, hey, Laszlo, your wife, she didn't like yesterday's dinner after I eat. You're not so happy. It's a big difference.
Anyway,
the marriage is impossible, Laszlo. If a man was born an angel,
for a drink, one thing leads to another, and before you know it, he's found all kinds of uses for the office furniture.
Exactly that. I know what you are like. A woman. A dreamer. A man who has needs. But an idiot. And I...
Miguel certainly has some of that famous Latin stamina. I'm quite exhausted. We underestimated Catalina's plans for Spank. It reaches far beyond the Yardies selling it on the street corners. The cartel have a front company, the Kappa Coffee House. They've been selling Spank through the street stalls. We have no choice but to put these drug stands out of operation. Smash them to splinters!
You, I love you. But you, more likely, your marriage is wrong. Your sweetheart, she hates you. Your pretty secretary, she wants you to be her man. You back it to square one. My friend, you and 1,000 men like you have been But then one day, I was driving my car, and I realized, Fernando, you are blessed. You are beautiful. Was rolling to one. You clean the marriage. And...
Fernando, my name's Jerry, and I'm a first-time caller. And I just wanted to say, See? I remember Jerry so well. He'd come in, he is like a broken man. Like a half a man. A million. He has no end. And his marriage, it is killing him. Where is the passion? She is gone. Replaced by Olin. You see, Laszlo, Mrs. Jerry, she's not a pretty lady. Him so many young, and he comes to me, and he cries, Fernando, save my marriage. I love my wife, even though she is a support. And I say, Jerry, you are a man. It is a man's duty to love his wife, even if she is like a farmer. And now, Jerry is saved.
But...
Killer bees.
Yes, killer bees. Did you know that if the current migration does continue, we will
Mr. Harvey said in 3 years. Did you want to become a bean stepper?
I don't. That's why we must act now. Killer bees must be stopped.
I wonder why more people aren't talking about this game. Killer bees swarming, and it sounds pretty serious.
But the killer bees are nothing compared to this. You can't kill them. They're like sheep. They're going to take over.
All right, thanks, caller. And killer bees, bad people, what's plaguing you? Call now. Chatterbox, hello, you're on the air.
Yes.
Train? And it says, in nearby Carcer City. Good day for law and order as Police Chief Gary Schaefer was cleared of corruption charges in a controversial decision by the courts. Let's hope those missing witnesses turn up safe and sound.
Lips 106.
We've got a new friend for everyone. He's got fur and a tail. He gets a nice color, but he's a fancy little fellow. Because he's got springs for legs. That's new video game for the whole family.
I love you, Hogo. You bound.
Help Hogo escape from evil research. research laboratory with a mean old scientist to never
know. Uh-oh, the pharmaceutical scientist is going to get you, Coco.
Here you go, Coco. Have a gold coin.
Good thing Coco has banana candy. Those nasty scientists deserve to die. Now get the shampoo manufacturers before they squirt it in your eye.
Pogo, have a diamond.
You'll guide Pogo to tons of fun adventures, including seeing a chicken who fell down the well.
Well, now.
that so much. One hair on himself that was off the bed with no dinner. What? Put to bed a hungry old 20, David 39. He learned. Now he brings his mother lunch to bed every day so he can sleep in. Let me tell you, everyone who has their kids serve it up, he cooks for the whole family. These days he gets too big. Then I have a paralegal break in a pumpkin. Never take a match. 23,000 a year. And on weekends, he doesn't go to the mall, play soccer, speed, or do any of that kind of stuff. No, no. He works the basement of a pumpkin company. Hell, if you go to sleep during the day, that's another $8,000 right there. Now, I'm buying me a fastboat trip. What do you say to that?
Well, it sounds kind of like exploitation to me.
Exploitation. That's a kill.
But it's good to know it's there. With the time I save taking shortcuts through the strip mall parking lot, I can focus on important things. Like gazing longingly at the pool boy or buying more exercise equipment on the TV. So what if you get 3 miles to the gallon? I'm a mom, not a conservationist. And you're my Batsu monstrosity. Mine is bigger.
Would you like a giraffe? One delivered. Just log on to PetsOvernight.com and we'll send you a giraffe overnight. PetsOvernight.com, delivering little bundles of love in a box directly to your door.
All right, you are listening to Chatterbox, hosted by me, Laszlo, because I got kicked off the rock station. Let's go over here and talk to somebody about their life. Hello, caller, you're on the air.
Hi,
Laszlo.
My name is Martha. I love your show. I always
talk about it. Probably not. You're listening to Chatterbox. Your opinion matters, or at least we say that. Let's go over here to line four. Hello, caller. What's your name?
Jeff LeBlanc.
Hello, Jeff. What's up?
I wanted to tell you and your listeners about a once-in-a-lifetime chance to make a difference. The rally call you Although it was Katie Shannon, she all night and all day to prepare for it. When tens of thousands gathered to talk.
Learning some real skills. How about the salary and benefits?
Yesterday, I made a dollar.
See, that's the kind of dedication we have to our employees and the quality of our shoes. Harris running shoes. Always running. Or something.
Buying a gift for the guy that has everything? Log on to petsovernight.com. We've got exotic pets galore.
Just wait for it to turn black and fall off.
Give it a quick prod.
Oh, what is that gooey yellow stuff? Oh, hey, babe!
My handyman.
I was bored, so I came over to keep Asuka company.
She's got the makings of a natural, this girl. She's managed to extract this little gem from our guest. There's a plane coming into Francis International in 2 hours' time. It is full of Catalina's poison. You can avoid airport security by getting a boat out to the runway light buoys and shooting the plane down on its approach. Collect the cargo from the debris and stash it.
Oh, you be careful now, okay, baby?
Now try the chili oil.
9 men after morning meditation and a speaking solid. I can tell about that now.
No offense, but you're kind of a strong beast, you do. This isn't the inside cover of your book that you still live in your parents' basement.
Okay, it's not a basement. You carnivore, when I... Subsisting with diet is not very difficult.
Yes, and they lose them to their own shadow and died of old age and fear and weakness.
Gradual, fur, but let me answer the question. When I'm in trouble, or...
Now I just wait for it to turn black and fall off.
Steel.
How can I learn to beat up 10 guys at once?
Okay, first thing first, my man. You need to stop the negative thinking. The weapon that I found, just run away. That way you won't hear.
Thank you.
which means that the owner of the station has an important announcement to make. Let's go live to his office.
Hello, my name is Donald Love. You're listening to a Love Media station. Enjoy.
Wow, man, that was deep. You know, I really like working here. The station, it feels like my second family. Except that we have a snack machine. And I tell you, working here beats that.
Do we tighten it some more now, or just wait for it to turn black and fall off?
Give it a quick prod.
Says that e-commerce is brilliant.
Do we tighten it some more now, or just wait for it to turn black and fall off?
Give it a quick prod.
Oh, what is the... Someone now, or just wait for it to turn black.
Yesterday, I made a dollar.
See, that's the kind of dedication we have to our employees and the quality of our shoes. Fearless running shoes. Always running.
Thank you.
sports jacket. For the lady in your life, why not pull the monkey chocolates and hygiene products if she smells like a mint? And for kids, a life-size, living, breathing, springy monkey, all available at pogothemonkey.com.
All right, Liberty City, this is your talk radio show, Chatterbox, where your opinion matters. Let's go to the phones. Hello, caller, you're on...
Do we tighten it some more now, or just wait for it to turn black and fall off?
Give it a quick prod.
Oh, what is that gooey yellow stuff? Oh, hey, babe!
My handyman.
I was bored, so I came over to keep Asuka company.
She's got the makings of a natural.
Unlike those other exercise machines that require you to be awake, the Dormitron actually exercises you overnight. Let's learn a little bit more about it.
I'm trying everything, and I just couldn't lift those extra 200 pounds. It's starting to affect my marriage.
She was too big for me, and I'll sleep with anything.
The Abdometrix, the Biosize, it's on me stapling. I've had my mouth sewn up, my hands chopped off. You name it, I've tried it.
Yeah, except for exercising and eating right, Walkie.
That's right. Then I found the Dormitron. Using a new technology called biorhythmic subconscious gymnastics, the Dormitron exercises your legs. Just strap in your arms and legs, put on the Dormitron headset, and back yourself with a special high-voltage electric blanket. Turn it on to 11 and burn those pounds away while you have a relaxing night's sleep. Now that I've lost 280 pounds, my will fall apart again.
That's right, honey. No more escort services for me.
Don't be fat a day longer than you have to. Remember, be fat can even ruin a romantic cruise.
load of manure.
And they get with your voice going up like this.
Don't mock me. I know where you work. You're just a color rat.
How's that?
All right, it's evil, dude. And Tuesdays, they use it to control us. Why do you think I'm freshman studying freshman for today? I have read books.
And what book have you been reading that tells you that Tuesdays are evil?
Entrance to the Devil's Great Cabin Cover by J. Bill Higginbotham. See what I've seen? Heard what I've heard? You never brush your teeth again.
I suppose you're one of those people that says that diet soda makes you go crazy later.
I told you before, man. Don't mock me. My taxes pay your salary, you...
...who pays my salary. And on that note, it's been 2 full minutes since a commercial. But I'd like to say, if anyone else is stressed, why not I recommend you for Oxford Fonzu Pharmaceuticals? We'll be back after these important messages.
Hello?
I used to be concerned and nervous about the future. Sometimes I'd get scared before an important event such as childbirth or a family funeral. Hey, sometimes you need a little help navigating life's trouble spots. That's when I discovered Equinox.
After the divorce and losing Uncle Tommy, life was getting me down. I couldn't focus on anything. After trying Equinox, I've been employed for a month 3 times in a row. I used to blow unconscious for hours at a time. But now with Equinox, I never...
I don't need a Sony ID. You don't know.
Another award-winning show on Chatterbox. Today we're talking about anything, it seems. If you have something to say about anything, call now. Hello, caller. You're on Chatterbox.
Yeah, I love the show. I love your people's faces. That's made this kind of-
patient one is about gun kill patient. Gun from kill patient. Death kill patient. That's the doctor. Medical fact. Bullet. After cardiac arrest or organ failure or major hemorrhage, small piece of metal ain't the problem. Besides, I only use my machine gun to take my own home in the car. I ain't hurt nobody. In countries that don't have guns ain't America.
You know, that's a really good point. Countries that don't have guns aren't America. You know, if more people had guns, we'd have less shootings in this country. All right, we're going over here to line two. Hello, caller. You are on Chatterbox.
Yeah, I'd like to say something about that.
You mean the Lone Star State?
Oh, Dax. Look, Dax is really wrong. My father worked his whole life. He played the lottery. And now the state wants to pay taxes on the money he wins from that stuff. Buy your own lottery tickets, you know? Hey.
Good point. I think that's a lesson to us all. All right. Hello, you are on Chatterbox.
Hello, Dr. Sergeant.
Oh, really? How do you like it? I mean, is it hard to get used to the language? You speak English pretty good.
Yes, I do. When I was a boy, I had a nanny. She was steady.
Yeah, well, I mean, there's excellent child care here in America.
Well, I'm sure. But the thing is, lads, though, when I was a naughty boy, I would get spanked. Nanny would spank me when I was naughty. And now Freddy needs a nanny. Because when Freddy's naughty, he needs to get spanked.
Well, there's some child psychologists that probably say that spanking can be harmful to a child's emotional development.
Absolute right, Lazlo. It's lovely. Freddy needs a nanny. He needs a nanny, Lazlo, because Freddy's been a very good boy.
How old is your son? How old is your son? All right, that's enough of him. God, who gave this guy a green card? This is Chatterbox. We're talking about short guys, nannies, taxes, and anything sane you'd like to bring to the party. Hello, you are on Chatterbox.
I was listening to that caller about taxes. You were a little extreme. Do you expect to be a responsible member of society? You don't understand how the government spends your money. Why are people afraid of numbers? I don't know about it. We'll get this incredible discovery of humanity. I mean, Cartesian coordinates have known how to know. I find it liberating.
Okay, thanks for calling. Now that we've lost 98% of our audience, let's reward the other 2% with a commercial. When we come back, we'll have a special studio guest. Special because he advertises on this radio station. Remember, it's not a conflict of interest if we own all the radio.
And they'll set you up with all your 21st century technology needs.
I only spent $20,000, and now I can get email in the shower or surf the internet while I'm driving. I was bored stupid at my daughter's recitals and my son's Little League games. Now, thanks to House of Tomorrow, I can play wireless head-to-head 3D virtual reality poker literally anywhere.
If it's a flash in the pan technology of absolutely no use to...
Revolutionary new way of saving your marriage. Fernando, welcome.
The pleasure is mine, Lazlo. It is an honor to meet you. I feel blessed.
Thanks. So, tell me about Fernando's new beginnings.
Truly, Lazlo, it is a miracle.
Fernando!
It is a revolution in the marriage life. For my people, marriage is, how to say, sacred. The bond between the father and the mother, it is made in heaven. And
I think so.
For my people, it is the holiest, most sacrosanct thing imaginable, like a church. Yet, for it to be a happy marriage, it must also be like a brothel. The woman, she must be many, many arts. A skill in making house, cooking, changing the diapers on the babies. And she must also be a whore. Imaginative, exotic, constantly. It is impossible. You change diapers and then you are a French man? Fernando thinks not. Fernando.
Well, I mean, you know, it's an age-old problem. How do you keep the excitement in America?
Excitement, exactly. Passion, danger.
How, Laszlo? How? Tell me how, and I give you a big, big kiss. Like I give a woman. But I am not going to give you a big kiss. Not a kiss like I give a woman or even a donkey. Because you do not know.
Well, I mean, in this case, ignorance kind of seems like bliss. I wasn't really up for kissing on air. I mean,
why not, Laszlo? Am I not attractive? Am I not irresistible to you? Well, no matter. Why are you talking about this?
I mean, you brought it up.
No, my friend. You say you not want to kiss me. I was talking about to say, hypothetically, you make me an old person. It's a bit different. If I say, imagine if your wife kisses me, it's not your head. But if I say, hey, Laszlo, your wife, she looked like yesterday's dinner after I eat. You not so happy. It's a bit different.
Anyway,
the marriage is impossible, Laszlo. If a man was born an angel, maybe it's possible. But a man is born a man with needs. He needs a woman to help his babies keep him in bed. But for his bed, he needs something else. Something magical.
So he starts flirting with his secretary, takes her out for a drink. One thing leads to another, and before you know it, he's found all kinds of uses for the office furniture.
Exactly that. I know what you are like. Who has needs, but an idiot, and I can save you, and I can save your marriage.
My marriage doesn't need saving.
Hey, you are the one mentioning the pretty assistant and the office manager and the iPad. I'm not
listen,
very closely. Your marriage is a gift. It's a present from me, but you are a man. I think we see by now you are no angel. I can save you. But when the man, he sees wife all fat, all ugly, with a dirty diaper, and a dirty bag, and a scrubby brush, and who knows what else. He's not thinking of marriage, babe. He's thinking about, well, you're thinking about your pretty assistant. We are ready.
Si, si, bueno. Pa que es idiot? One of these scar-faced idiots.
The real question is, did you turn up to rescue Maria or to get me back? Well, I got news for you. Shooting you will be a pleasure, but dating you was only business. You are muy pequeñito, amigo. Throw over the cash. You have been a busy boy, but you haven't learned. I'm not to be trusted. Kill the idiot!
Going to be sorry. Run or die. I risk it, gringo. I'm going to kill you. I risk it, gringo. I'm going to be sorry.
you act like a pimp?
Not a pimp. A savior. In a control environment, I reintroduce the man to the creator of the law, to the miracle of the world. And through the results are remarkable. With my investment, 1,000 marriages have been saved, and 1,000,000 more could be saved every day.
And do the wives know about this?
In their hearts, Laszlo, they know they have
okay. We're going to open it up to the phones. If you've got any questions for Fernando Martinez, Exotic Marriage Guidance Made Easy, ring us now. Hey, oh, cool, we have a caller on line one. Caller, you are on Chatterbox.
Hi, Laszlo. Hey, Fernando. My name's Jerry, and I'm a first-time caller. And I just wanted to say, hey, Laszlo, you're real tough on Fernando back there. I'll tell you one thing. He's a miracle worker. Saved my marriage, and I married a bus girl. Now I don't feel sick every time I open my eyes.
See that, look? You see? I remember Jerry so well. He come in, he is like a broken man. Like a half a man. A minute. He has no end anymore. And his marriage, it is killing him. Where is the passion? She is gone. Replaced by an ugly man. You see that, look? Mrs. Jerry, she's not a pretty lady. She's more like an offensive lion, or a... And I say, Jerry, you are a man. It is a man's duty to love his wife, even if she is like a farmer. And now, Jerry, say,
by sleeping with other women.
But the woman to save
a beautiful union by an adulterer and Queen Kong. That's great. So, who's on the line now?
Hi, Lando. It's Jeff. I love the show and always wanted to call in. You really offended me.
Hey, Janice, I share your anxiety. The studio kind of forced him on me.
Hey, you like yourself, mister. And you, Janice, why are you so ugly? Your husband, he don't make you happy.
No, he's an idiot and a jerk.
But he's probably a good daddy, and you sound very pretty. Angry, and a little bit of a toy, but very pretty. This is the thing, that's why. The women, they think in your beginning, it's only for men. But no, it is for women, too. For Janice, she thinks that you're wonderful all over again. And in the extreme case, maybe she comes to work for me. And she gets a new beginning herself. She discovered the excitement and the passion all for herself. This is Janice. You called me 555-9292.
Now listen, don't try to pimp out my listeners.
That is a very ugly word. A travesty. I work miracles, senor. Not pimping. I say, I give the passion back. And you better wash yourself, buddy. Because for my people, we take these issues very personally. And then, you know how to trust you. You missed your hooker on my tongue.
Who are your people anyway, man? Which exotic location do you come from?
I am Latin.
Latin is a big place there, buddy. But where is
Latin? I do not need to listen to these insults. I have pride. I have a calling. Many are called, but you are chosen, my friend. And I was called and chosen. The world, a miracle.
So, where were you called from, Fernando?
From upstate, okay? Do I have any money now? I'm not real Latin, but I provide real Latin passion. I work the miracles every day. Listen, wives, children, if your husband, if your daddy, if he not happy, then he could meet Fernando. In exchange for a few hours a week, I give you the world!
Get off, get lost! You're just a cheap pimp from upstate! Get out of my studio!
I save your daddy! I saved your husband! It is a miracle!
Get out of here!
It's a miracle!
Would you like a kitten? Have one delivered. Just log on to petsovernight.com and we'll...
Si, buen...
Kill you.
drinking water. Listen, if there's any sane person left in Liberty City that can hear my voice, please call the show right now. This is an SOS going out across the city. All right, let's go over to this line. Hello, caller. You are on the air. Are you sane? Are you a sane caller?
Absolutely, Lazlo. Killer bees.
Killer bees.
Yes, killer bees. Did you know that if the current migration does continue, we will all be dead in 3 years? Did you want to become a bee stopper? I don't. That's why we're talking about killer bees must be stopped.
I don't know what people are talking about. This is a killer bee swarming, and it sounds pretty serious.
Ah, but the killer bees are nothing compared to ants. You can't kill them. They're like sheep. They're going to take over.
All right, thanks, caller. Ants, killer bees, bad people, what's plaguing you? Call now. Chatterbox, hello, you're on the air.
I'd like to say something about the damn people on trains and buses in the city and the ones that monitor their cell phones. I'm really glad to get to hear about what's coming to dinner. What we should do is turn them up and put them on an island. I am the president of a group called Citizens for a Decent Campus.
Crap.
Exactly.
Your organization is called Crap. What kind of moron are you? You're around people up and using a phone? But you're calling up on a phone to tell the world about it. Wait. How many people are there in this crap?
Citizens are raging against phones, Lazlo.
How many people?
There are three of us. It's hard organizing meetings without the phone, though. We've had to resort to carrier pigeons and they keep disappearing.
What are you speaking to me on? What's that in your hand?
I am not the problem. You are. You're perpetuating the downfall of mankind. Liberty City was great before phones ruined everything.
Liberty City was a church, a cow pasture, and three houses when the telephone was invented.
Liar, liar, pants on fire.
What are you? Are you 3 years old?
Lazlo's a liar. Lazlo's a liar. I bet that isn't even your real name.
Shut up.
You shut up.
Stupid.
Nanny, nanny, boo boo. Stick your head in doo doo.
Oh, for going to commercial.
Is your job affecting your health? Do you become fatigued? Does working take time away from family and social events like watching? There's an easy solution. Sue your boss. See, the great thing about this country is you can sue anyone for pretty much anything, and you'll probably win, or at least get a settlement. At the firm of Rankin & Concert Personal Injury Attorneys, we can show you how falling down and howling like a sissy can result in a large damage award from your employer. We also specialize in awards for injuries suffered in auto, bus, and train accidents, and can even train you to throw yourself in front of a bus and pretend to be injured. Hey, that's why they pay for insurance. Call the law offices of Rankin & Concert and get ready to enjoy a life of luxury.
All right, we're back on Chatterbox. Let's go to the chatter line here. Hello, caller. You're on Chatterbox.
Lazlo, I just wanted to make your viewers aware that...
Okay, now, this is a radio show. We don't have viewers. We have listeners.
Okay. Anyway, Lazlo, I just wanted to make your viewers aware the first international infantry festival was next month at the fairgrounds, bro. If you're interested in becoming a puppet master or a ventriloquist, you should definitely come...
Genuine reproduction medieval artifacts, including maces, double-handed battle swords, and one-size-fits-all chainmail. And this weekend only, pick up an authentic mechanical Lady of the Lake.
All right, let's take a call. Who's on the line?
Rose.
What about them?
Rose.
What are you talking about?
Laszlo. I hate him. I just hate him.
Wait, we're all about opinions on Chatterbox. Because all Liberty stands here. Why don't you like him?
I just hate them. It's okay to break them. I mean, does the lion work well? And the lion is a king of the jungle. Why can't I own a citizen? Go and make it.
Well, I mean, I guess the lion has two distinct amazing things. As you say, a king, and therefore can exercise his royal prerogative to not wear clothes. Two, it's a cat, and therefore doesn't have to. Three, I mean, now that I think about it, if you want to try to dress a lion, you can, but I guess what we're learning is that life can be a little unfair at times.
I take it, Laszlo. I take it.
You know, I really didn't need to know that.
Why, Laszlo? Why? Said you? I was born naked in 10,000, and I'm going to live naked. So there's nothing wrong with being naked. Sort of figuring to the hot weather on the shore, where the cool wind is blowing up your naked body.
I'm gonna have to cut you off.
Don't you believe in free speech? Free expression? No, of course you don't. All you believe in is free drink. I'm naked, there's not a damn thing you can do about it. I'm naked and I just...
Si, bueno.
Hey, you brave man, eh? Wrong or die? To be sorry. I'm going to see you again. I re-escaped.
this thing airborne!
Residents in Cedar Grove have been coming to terms with the emotional aftermath of a full-blown war that hit the area yesterday. Local resident Clive Denver described to police a single gunman that he saw fleeing the scene with a dark-haired woman.
Gonna have such fun, because you know I love you. I really do, because you're such a big, strong man, and that's just what I need. Anyway, what was I saying? I forget, but you know what it's like, don't you?
The sound of explosions shook nearby homes as people ran for cover. Several citizens were injured in the panic as gunfire was exchanged between ground forces and a helicopter circling the dam.
Yeah, we got a good view from down here in the gardens. When the copter finally got taken out, better than the fireworks on the 4th of July.
With the death toll already over 20, police are still finding bodies. There have been no official denials concerning rumors that the dead were members of the Colombian cartel, and still no leads as to the cause of the massacre.
I broke a nail and my hair is ruined. I mean, can you believe it? This one cost me $50.